when we first got married and started having kids, my husband was in school, I was working, and so we had to have childcare.
Should we find a bigger one?
But we had to put it all on student loans because I just simply was not making enough. But we also made just a little bit too much to get help and assistance.
That costly childcare debt, Christy DeGraff says she is still paying off to this day. Christy says it was so difficult and expensive to find good childcare for her two children. It's part of the reason she knew she had to do something.
Once my husband had a job with benefits and insurance and a steady income, we sort of flip-flopped.
You made the rock?
It was better for me to be running my program and then being able to care for my own kids versus putting them all in childcare.
Now running Learning Tree Childcare in Cedar City, this helped solve Christy's problem. But she says it's difficult seeing so many parents struggle to find high-quality childcare.
The problem is, it's always full.
Once they do find a spot for their child, then paying the bill is a struggle for many.
Squash it harder.
On the one hand, if you qualify for assistance, that is really helpful. In Cedar City, most providers are charging about what assistance will pay, so most parents don't have extra that they have to pay on top of that. It's really hard for those families in the middle who are not quite making enough to afford it, but make too much to be able to qualify for assistance.
Between materials and investing in good teachers, Christy says it costs a lot to provide quality care.
And we have matching shapes.
Really, if I were going to charge parents enough to pay my teachers a living wage, to pay myself a decent wage, to keep up with all the projects and program improvement, I'd have to be charging them two or three times as much as I'm charging them.
Christy isn't sure what the solution is.
There's a gap in the middle that I don't think providers can continue to carry, and parents can't make up the difference. And so there's got to be some help in the middle, which is not necessarily always a popular solution for taxpayers or lawmakers.
But she does know if children are not in the home with a parent, they need to be somewhere with high-quality childcare. Otherwise, she believes we will see the repercussions of that as a society.
They found that investing in early childhood pays back like seven times in lower rates of crime, lower rates of poverty, better health, better mental health. It is so good for the whole community, but you can't see it right away. You have to wait 10, 20 years to really see the impacts of not investing in early childhood.
In Cedar City, for Utah Insight, I'm Rayanne Christensen.